The B-1B Lancer was pivotal in the U.S. air campaigns in Afghanistan and Iraq, earning a reputation as a versatile bomb truck delivering decisive air support. This aircraft was to be a long-range bomber, capable of countering the Soviet long-range nuclear bombers of the time. When the Soviet Union collapsed, the Lancer went through a bit of an identity crisis. However, all that changed with the global war on terror. The B-1B Lancer, despite being more than 30 years old, remains a vital asset for the U.S. Air Force. With 17 retired in 2021 and only 45 left, the Lancer will serve until the B-21 Raider is fully operational. The only problem is that the B-21 will not be ready anytime soon to replace the Lancer, and that could take a really long time. Instead, the Air Force should refurbish and retain the Lancers until sufficient B-21 bombers are available, avoiding a critical gap in U.S. air power. So, a critical function that the B-1B Lancer performs, and that the B-21 is supposed to replace, will be operating in a degraded fashion for years to come. Despite this, the Air Force persists in pushing ahead with its plan to retire the Lancer fleet by the end of the 2020s. The B-21 is an essential next step for the Air Force. And if the Air Force were serious about deterring China in any meaningful timeline, then it would divest itself from the wasteful sixth-generation warplane and reallocate those funds into meeting the B-21 order as quickly as possible. The Lancer is a long-range, multi-mission, supersonic conventional bomber which has flown missions for the Air Force since 1985. B-1 were originally conceived as a nuclear-capable bomber. By the time the Soviet Union had collapsed and the Cold War was over, the Air Force switched the Lancers to exclusively conventional armaments. The Lancers acquitted themselves with honor during America's multiple post-Cold War conflicts, in America's air war against Serbia to stop their attacks on Kosovo, just 6 B-1 flew 2% of the combat missions. These handful of B-1 dropped 20% of the ordnance, though. During this time, the Air Force completed significant modernizations to the B-1B Lancer. The Lancers would deploy the GBU-54 laser joint direct attack munition, allowing for the force's air component commander to engage and destroy moving targets with the Lancer for the first time ever. The Lancers expanded their footprint both in Afghanistan and Iraq and enjoyed a high success rate. From the first moments, the CIA's jawbreaker paramilitary teams and U.S. Special Operations Forces busted covertly into the notoriously rough land and linked up with the indigenous tribes aligned against the Taliban and Al-Qaeda, the Americans conducted the first phase of the war with great alacrity. It was the B-1B Lancer that usually answered the call of those embedded operators, circling a battlefield and delivering death and destruction to the terrorists below. These were the halcyon days, when victory seemed assured in what would become America's longest war. The negative turn in the failed war was still months away, and even then, the Lancer would define the air war for the country. Not only were the Lancers highly devastating in Afghanistan, but they were used to great effect in Iraq as well. In fact, in 2008, the U.S. Air Force's official website labeled the B-1B Lancer as one of the most important bombers in that war. The lessons learned from Afghanistan were quickly carried over to the war in Iraq in 2003, with the Lancers conducting an assortment of close air support missions. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video, because I appreciate all your support.